Could you please give this a once over? I do not have time to look at them.
But I don't even know what they're applying for. Oh well. Nope. No. AI for teddy bears? Okay.
When you're applying for a job alongside hundreds of other applicants, your cover letter needs to look knockout. Otherwise, it could end up in this pile. And we all know what happens with this pile. I'll make sure you're covered on cover letters.
You see what I did there?
Hi, I'm Miko from the Vibe team at Canva. Did you know recruiters only read 17% of the applications they receive? It's disheartening, I know. But that's why it's crucial to nail your cover letter. So, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to whip up a design that'll stand out from the rest and convince your future employer it's worth the read. First, we'll cover what to include and how to pick the right template for your industry. And then I'll show you how to make it your own by adding colours, fonts, and graphics. Sound good? Hit that subscribe button so you get notified next time we post a video. I'll start by typing cover letter into search. There are so many designs to choose from. Some are simple and chic, while others are vibrant and punchy. If you work in a conservative industry, you may want to play it safe. But if you're applying for a job that's creative or people-centered, why not go bold? Whichever you decide, take note of the crown symbol because these templates are for Pro and Canva for Teams users, but all the rest are free for anyone to use. You could always buy a one-off license just for a dollar. Okay, let's start with something simple like this and pretend it's for an accounting role. To edit the text, simply double-click and start typing. Change the contact details here. I wouldn't include your home address. I can't think of any reason why they might need your street address. It's not like they're going to send you a gift or pop over for a cup of tea. Maybe they do. It's never happened to me before. That doesn't mean it's not a thing. Anyway, when it comes to adding personal info, I like to keep everything up top so it's easy to find and only include the basics, phone number and email, just the ways that you want to be contacted. Websites and social media handles can be handy, but only if you've got something to show on there. Otherwise, leave them for the rest of the resume. Ultimately, you don't want the recruiter becoming distracted. They should be focusing on what you've written and not on your design. Now I've added the contact info, I'll move on to the letter itself. I'll remove this section. It's not really needed these days. They know where they are. Select it, hit delete on your keyboard, and it's gone. I'll keep the name of the person and the role. This is important if that person isn't there anymore. Then it will go to the new person in that role. You can see that the designer has set up a number of text boxes here. Since I've already prepared my letter, I can simply get rid of these and paste in the text. Now this text is what we call left aligned, right ragged. You could go justified by clicking this button. This will line up your text on both sides, but it could create some holes in it. I tend to think right ragged is easier to read. Because the right-hand side is uneven, it's actually easier for the eye to track which line's next. Don't, whatever you do, go for centered text. Center-aligned text should only be used for small sections of text or on movie posters. Okay, with most applications being submitted digitally, you won't have the opportunity to sign your name by hand. To create a digital signature, you have two options. Start by signing your name on a piece of paper, photographing it, and uploading it like this. If you're a Pro or Canva for Teams user, you can remove the background by going to Edit Image and hitting this button. The other option is to bring up the contrast so the white drops away. You could also apply a little transparency. I guess you could also use a script font, but that might look a little weird. The point of the signature is to make it feel authentic. If you just use a script font, it won't communicate this. Speaking of fonts, let's take a look at applying some different styles to the rest of the text. For the heading, I'd like something with a bit more character. That's better. Next, I'll select a different font for the main text. Something simple and easy to read is always best. I can change all by hitting this button to make sure it's all uniform. I'll change the heading to blue as it represents calmness and dedication, two qualities this employer might find appealing. Since the header and footer are made up of shapes, I can make a new colour combo by changing one at a time. All right, with that done, it's ready to share. First, I'll show you how to download a copy because most cover letters are requested as a PDF file. Simply head to Share, click here, and select PDF Standard. Once you hit Download, a copy will save to your desktop and you'll be able to upload it to a range of recruitment platforms or attach it to an email. You could also supply them with a view-only link. Just go back to the panel and click this icon to generate a shareable link. This is what it will look like. Simple, isn't it? Want to know why I love this option? Not only does it save time, but it enables you to see how many times the link has been used, meaning you can figure out if an employer has actually looked at it or not. You'll see a new insights button has appeared when I made the link. By clicking on it, you can see the total number of views and viewers. These numbers can be a good indication of how your application is progressing. For example, say there's been 3 total views and only 1 viewer. That means someone's looked at your cover letter multiple times and may seriously be considering you for the role. If there's multiple viewers, it means they're sharing your letter around. Pretty handy, huh? Did you already know about insights? If you're learning about this for the first time, drop me a comment. I'd love to know. We've still got loads to cover, like how to add a hyperlink and when to include a profile shot. But let's move on to another design. To save some time, I've picked a template and switched the text already. This is more for a creative role, so I'm keen for the recruiter to look at the website. To make it easy for them, I'll turn it into a link. Simply highlight the text, then click this icon. Now type or paste the website in here and hit done. You can do the same to autofill emails as well. Just instead of adding a website, fill in your email address. That way, when an employer needs to get in contact, they can just hit the link and send you an email in seconds. Let's just hope it's the good kind. All right, let's discuss whether to include a headshot, because there are some pros and cons either way. By including a friendly snapshot, you may appear more relatable, more human, but this can also invite bias. A high-quality photo can help recruiters put a face to a name. However, an unprofessional shot could give them the wrong impression. Whether you choose to include one or not really boils down to personal preference. But as a general rule, I'd say if in doubt, leave it out. If you've waited up and still want to include one, let me show you how. To switch the existing photo, I'll upload my own and drag it over the top. By hovering it close to the original, it will automatically drop in. Even if there's no photo to begin with, it's easy to add your own. Simply select the one you want, resize it, and drag it into position. Or add a frame if you prefer a unique shape. Just go to the Elements tab, type in Frame, and select the one that you want. Now I can drag and drop in the photo like I did before. Okay, we've covered hyperlinks, photos, colors, and fonts. We haven't spent much time exploring graphic elements. So before we wrap up, let's take a quick look at what's possible. I love this template, but it looks like a cover letter for a candy store. So let's switch out some elements to suit a childcare worker. First, I'll replace the candy with something crafty. Ah, this will work. Then, I'll remove the corner graphics and replace them with graphics that relate to the role. And finally, I'll change out that handwritten font for something that's simpler to read. Make a few more little adjustments. Nice! As you can see, it doesn't even need to be difficult or time-consuming. Pick the right template and you're already halfway there. And now that you've watched this video, you're even closer to achieving your goal of creating an epic cover letter. All you need to do is jump into Canva and make a start. But before you do, let me know what style of template you plan to use. Did you like the first, second, or third design I showed you? Let me know in the comments, along with your questions. If you found this video useful, please like and share it for others to enjoy. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on our next video. We release them weekly and they keep getting better and better. Don't believe me? Watch this one and decide for yourself. Or check out the whole playlist over here. See you next time.